Hello learners, welcome to the course BSW 4.1, Understanding Tribals. This week we are going to discuss the topic Tribal Indigenous Entity, Part 1 from the Unit 4. After going through this unit, the learner would understand the concept of indigenous people. The learner would also understand the important characteristics of indigenous people and other few important areas, like we are going to discuss the relationship between the different international bodies and indigenous people, and also try to understand the concept of indigenous people in the Indian context. Now let us discuss the concept of indigenous people, because it has been a hot topic of debate within academic circle as well as in the government, particularly in India. The past experience of discrimination, dispossession, marginalization and subjugation was a major concern for the indigenous people, both at the national as well as at the international level. In the present day nation state system, many marginalized people are claiming the indigenous status. With the increasing recognition of the concept of indigenous people in the international law and by the international organizations, national governments are forced to address the problem of identifying the indigenous people to whom the respective laws and policies apply. Now let us discuss the definition and criteria of indigenous people. The concept of indigenous people is a truly complex and contentious topic. What constitutes indigenous people, or how to measure it? It is not very clear, and thus it's very complex. Although several attempts have been made by scholars, practitioners and legal experts, there is no universally accepted definition of indigenous people. The universal definition is also not necessary or desirable due to the existence of diversities among the indigenous people. So these regional and national approaches differ from each other on the basis of their respective social context. This notion, which has been emphasized by the United Nations declarations on the rights of the indigenous people, where it has been pointed out that there is a need to take into consideration the existing national and regional factors while defining the concept of indigenous people. The etymological meaning of indigenous is the native belonging naturally to the soil. It means those whose ancestors were the original inhabitants of lands and later colonized or settled by others. The dominant issue of indigenous revolves around the fact that who came first or who occupied the territory first. In colonial countries, there exists a clear distinction between indigenous people and those who came in later waves of migration. The term indigenous people, indigenous ethnic minorities, tribal groups, and scheduled tribes describes a social group with a social and cultural identity distinct from the dominant society. So this makes them vulnerable and being disadvantaged in the development process. We all know that indigenous people are the poorest segment of the society. Their economic activities range from shifting agriculture in a near forest area, or they are involved in small-scale market-oriented activities and so on. Thus, different national and international institutions and organizations have developed their own understanding of the concept of indigeneity or indigenous people in their own respective context. Now, considering the diversity of indigenous people, an official definition of indigenous has not been adopted by the United Nations system body. Instead, the system has developed a modern understanding of this term based on the following. Firstly, self-identification as indigenous people at the individual level and accepted by the community as their members. Secondly, the historical continuity with pre-colonial and or pre-settler societies. Thus, international body has adopted both working as well as operational definition of indigenous people. Now, let us look at the working definition. They state that It states that indigenous populations are composed of the existing descendants of the people who inhabited the present territory of a country wholly or partially at the time when persons of a different culture or ethnic origin arrived from there from other parts of the world, overcome them and by conquest settlement or other means, reduce them to be non-dominant or colonial condition, who today live more in conformity with their particular social, economic and cultural customs and traditions than the institutions of the country of which they now form part under a state structure which incorporates mainly the national, social and cultural characteristics of other segments of the population which are predominant. Now let us look at the operational definition of the UN states that indigenous communities, people and nations are those which having a historical continuity with pre-invasion and pre-colonial societies that developed on their territories, consider themselves distinct from other sections of the societies now prevailing in those territories or parts of them. They form at present non-dominant sectors of society and are determined to preserve, develop and transmit to future generations their ancestral territories and their ethnic identity as the basis of their continuous existence as people, in accordance with their own cultural patterns, social institutions and legal systems. So, the indigenous people are those who have a historical continuity and consider themselves ethnically different from others, and they are the non-dominant group. Erica Irene Diaz, chairperson of the UN Working Group on Indigenous People, acknowledged the existing diversities among the social groups and defined certain people as indigenous due to the following features. Now let us look at these features. Because there are descendants of groups which were in the territory of the country at the time when other groups of different culture or ethnic origins arrived there. Because of their isolation from other segment of the country's population, they have preserved almost intact the customs and traditions of their ancestors, which are similar to those characterized as indigenous, and because they are even if only formally placed under a state structure which incorporates national, social and cultural and cultural characteristics alien to theirs. The United Nations Permanent Forum on Indigenous People has not adopted any official definition of indigenous people. Rather, it has developed a modern understanding of the term based on the following features. Firstly, self-identification as indigenous people at the individual level and accepted by the community as their member. Secondly, historical continuity with pre-colonial and or pre-settler societies. Thirdly, there is a strong link to territories and surrounding natural resources. And another important feature is distinct social, economic or political systems. And they also have a distinct language, culture and beliefs. They also form non-dominant groups of society. They resolve to maintain and reproduce their ancestral environments and systems as distinctive people and communities. The Convention 169 of the ILO defines indigenous people as who, on account of their descent from the populations which inhabited the country or a geographical region to which the country belongs at the time of conquest or colonization or the establishment of the present state boundaries, and who, irrespective of the legal status, retain some or all of their own social, economic, cultural and political institutions. Now let us see what are the less favorable living conditions and the lower social, economic and cultural status of such people prior to conquest or colonization, which are considered as the major criteria for indigenous status. It has focused on both objective as well as subjective criteria for defining the indigenous people. Let us see what are the objective criteria. The objective criteria of understanding indigenous people acknowledge the importance of their distinct social, cultural and economic conditions. Their status need to be regulated fully or partially by their own customs or traditions or by special laws or regulations. Now when we look at the subjective criteria of defining the concept of indigenous people based on the development of their self-identity, where it has been underlined that self-identification shall be regarded as a fundamental criterion for determining the group. This is based on the fact that a person is accepted as a belonging to a particular indigenous or tribal people and a person identified as belonging to a particular indigenous or tribal people. The World Council of Indigenous People in the year 1993 came up with its own definition. Indigenous people or such population groups as we are, who from age-old times have inhabited the lands where we live, who are aware of having a character of our own with social traditions and means of expressions that are linked to the country inherited from our ancestors, with a language of our own and having certain essential and unique characteristics which confer upon us the strong conviction of belonging to people who have an identity in ourselves and should be thus regarded by others. The World Bank defines indigenous people by some of the following characteristics. First, a close attachment to ancestral territories and to the natural resources there. Secondly, self-identification and identification by others as members of a distinct cultural group. Thirdly, an indigenous language, often different from the national one. And they also have customary social and political institutions and primarily substances producers. So based on the above definitions, what we have discussed and the characteristics, it can be stated that the claim for indigenous status demands some essential requirements as well as relevant indica. Let us now see what are the essential requirements. Firstly, the self-identification as a distinct ethnic group. Second, the historical experience of or contingent vulnerabilities to severe disruption, dislocation and exploitation. Thirdly, long connection with the region and they wish to retain a distinct identity. Let us see what are the relevant indica. They are non-dominant in the national or regional society. They are close cultural affinity with a particular area of land or territories. There is a historical continuity, especially by descent, with prior occupations of land in the region. The socio-economic and socio-cultural differences from the ambient population. The distinct objective characteristics such as language, race, material or spiritual culture, etc. And they are also regarded as indigenous by ambient population or treated as such in legal or administrative arrangements. Now, when we look at the centrality of defining indigenous people, is the attachment of the indigenous people to their territories. Another key element of the definition of indigenous people is the dimension of a relationship of dispossession or subordination in relation to another group that arrived later. So in short, we can say indigenous people are the ethnic groups that are defined as indigenous according to one of the various definitions of the term. There is no universally accepted definition, but most of which carry connotations of being the original inhabitants of a territory. Now, when we look at the political sense of the term indigenous people, that defines these groups as particularly vulnerable to exploitation and oppression by nation states. Indigenous people are the descendants of those who inhabited a country or a geographical region at the time when people of different cultures or ethnic origins arrived. The new arrivals later become dominant through conquest, occupation, settlement or other means. There are three aspects which are central to the conceptualization of indigenous people. First, the indigenous or those people who live in the country to which they belong before colonization or conquest by people from outside the country or the geographical region. Secondly, they have become marginalized as an aftermath of conquest and colonization by the people from outside the region. Thirdly, such people govern their life more in terms of their own social, economic and the cultural institution than the laws applicable to the society or the country. So learners, I hope you would have understood the concept of indigenous people and what are the important characteristics of the indigenous people. Thank you.